If you are age appropriate, 18 years or older, and healthy, you may qualify to be a living kidney donor and save a life. The most common reason for kidney donation is relationship ties, such as between family members and friends. However, we have seen increasingly that there are some living donors who come forward to donate a kidney to someone that they don't know personally, which is called non-directed donation. For one to be a kidney donor, they must have no evidence of kidney disease and no evidence of any major medical condition that may put them at risk in the future. For instance, as we know, diabetes is the most common cause of kidney disease. Therefore, my role is to ensure that living donors have no evidence of diabetes and their future risk of developing diabetes is acceptably low. Uncontrolled hypertension is a common cause of kidney disease. Therefore, living donor must have normal blood pressure for consideration. However, certain individuals with hypertension who are at age 50 years or older may donate a kidney safely as long as they have well-controlled hypertension and they have no other medical risk. Obesity is a major public health problem in the US. Obesity is associated with hypertension, diabetes, and hyperlipidemia. Therefore, we exclude donors with severe obesity. In general, we recommend donors to maintain healthy lifestyle and exercise to maintain their body weight in a normal range. Before donation, I do comprehensive reviews of medical history, urine tests, blood tests, and imaging studies. Our donors must meet strict criteria for consideration to ensure their short and long-term safety. After donation, our transplant coordinators will follow up with our donors with interval period lab tests and will make recommendations as needed to keep them in health. The surgery is usually a laparoscopic operation. It has low risk complication. Our donors usually leave the hospital in 2 to 3 days, resume their normal life with limited activity in 2 to 6 weeks. And after a 6 week period, life as it was before donating. The risk of kidney failure after kidney donation is low. In fact, it is lower than in general population. However, this is expected because our donors are healthier. Under the US kidney allocation system, prior donors receive priority for the waiting list for deceased donor and for high quality kidneys. The major advantage of receiving a kidney from a living donor is that a kidney from a living donor lasts significantly longer compared to a kidney from a deceased donor. For instance, the 50% graft survival of a kidney from a living donor is 14 years versus 10 years for a kidney from a deceased donor. In addition, by receiving a living kidney donor, you would avoid the long time on the waiting list for deceased donor, and of course, avoiding dialysis. First, at Johns Hopkins, donor safety comes first. We have multidisciplinary teams that they work together to ensure safety of donor. Second, our group have come with novel methods to accommodate incompatible kidney transplant. And last but not least, Johns Hopkins is a leading center in outcome research for living kidney donors.